you come to the altar, we want you to remember those in our sick and our shelters.
Yes, Lord.
Mother Margaret Easley, Sister Mildred Chappelle, Sister Katie Powell, Sister Dorothy Hall, Mother Aileen Brown, Sister Ruthie Green, Sister Jane Price, Sister Jane Robo, Sister Catherine Hall, Sister Mildred Sherrod. I also want to remember all those that are on our prayer and sickness.
Yeah.
All those that are in the hospitals.
Yeah.
All of those that are behind prison walls.
Yeah.
We also want to remember Brother Red Reginald Beckham, who fell off a ladder. But God is good. He's still here. Remember Sister Mae Miller, who says had cancer, but God is a healer. I was told this morning that she is now cancer free, but going through her chemo. We also want to remember Miss Eleanor Price.
Yes.
Down in Mississippi. Some have tried to write her off, but God hasn't called her yet. He has the final say-so. He has all the authority. He is the one with the final say. If there's anyone that are standing at the altar right now with anything or anyone on their mind, just lift up your hands right now and call it out to Jesus. He already knows what we're going through. He already knows what we need. He just said, if you ask, in a righteous mind, it shall be given unto you. Lord, this morning, we come to you this morning, Lord, with a bowed head and humble heart this morning, Father God. We come to you. Lord, there's so much going on in the world today, Father. Children are killing children. Folks are losing their lives in landslides. Folks are being lost and no one can find them. But we know, Father God, you still sit high and look low. What's going on, Father God? Because your son Jesus told us in his word that these things will come to pass before he returns for his children. Father God, there's nothing new under the sun. All these things you know about, Father God. You know the ones that are standing at your altar right now, Father God, that is in need of a mental breakthrough, Father God. You know the ones that are standing bless those that don't know you. And the part that they're saying this morning, Father, because according to your word, your son is due back sooner than most think. The times are showing themselves, Father. The times are coming. And Father, we just want to be ready when you return. Father, bless those that are graduating this morning, Father God. Just keep them, Father. Let them know that it was only because of you that they made it.
There's
nothing that we've done of our own except for your love, grace, and mercy that we're here this morning. And we thank you for that this morning. Lord, bless Reverend Smith and his family this morning. Bless me and my family this morning. Bless every one of your children under the sound of my weak voice this morning, Father God. Because we need you, Lord, in a mighty way. The devil is busy, Father. He's busy trying to kill, steal, and destroy. But I tell him this morning, he is a liar. Because we are children of the Most High. And you said that, Father, as long as we're in your hand, no one can remove us from it. And we thank you for that this morning, Father God. Thank you, Father, for that you, all that you brought us through, all that you are taking us to, and all that we're going to have to go through, Father, until that day that you return for us. But on that day, Father God, when you return for us, we all just want to hear you say, well done, my good and faithful servant. On that day, Father God, there'll be no more sickness. There'll be no more troubles. There'll be no more heartaches. We can just sit at your feet and rest. Father God, these and all blessings we ask, Father, in your Son Jesus' name. For our sake. Amen.
Amen.
Bless you.